2 months ago, I bought myself a birthday present, a new MacBook Pro with M1 Max silicon, and it really took 2 months to get here. I'm not a tech reviewer, but I wanted to run and compare some software performances with my old MacBook Pro from 2017, which is still great. I just got a keyboard recalled, so I have a new battery and all, but this new Apple silicon sounded so promising, so I just had to buy one for myself. Here's a detail for my MacBooks. On my left, a late 2017 model with a 16 gigabytes of RAM, and on my right is a 2021 model with M1 Max chip with 64 gigabytes of RAM. I'm going to test Apple Silicon native apps only, Blender, QuickTime, and DaVinci Resolve, and then I'll do some mic and webcam tests at the end. Blender now supports Metal GPU acceleration for Cycle. This is exciting because Cycle was CUDA only, so you'd need a window machine to take the advantage of beautiful Cycle at reasonable speed. So I've been using only EEVEE on my MacBook. This is one of my favorite video, compositing CFD result with a real video footage behind with camera motion tracking. So here's I'm rendering 140 frames of 3D streamlines with pre-calculated camera motions. For EEVEE rendering, I try to render 140 frames. Roughly M1 Max MacBook was 3 to 4 times faster. After 30 minutes, the new MacBook completed the work, while the old MacBook still had a long way to go, so I just stopped it. So it was only estimated to be done in 50 minutes. And this is very out of sync. Now for Cycle. To be fair, I compare with only CPU to CPU first, and then enable GPU for the new MacBook. This time I only render 10 frames. Okay. 2021 MacBook took 1/60 second. 2017 MacBook took 495 seconds, and that's about 3 times faster. Once M1 Max's GPU is enabled, the same procedure takes only 97 seconds. That's more than 500% improvement. So with Metal GPU support, the exporting time would be drastically shorter, but I'm more impressed with the real-time rendering capability that I've been only seeing on other Blender users with very expensive external GPUs. So I'm very out of excuse for my quality of the work. As you can see from my videos, QuickTime is my go-to video editing tool. I just collect footage from with my Osmo Pocket and then just simply combine them all together with very minimal effort. With 16 GB of the RAM, 2017 MacBook Pro sometimes freezes after merging more than 50 videos. 2021 MacBook came with 64 GB of RAM, so I haven't noticed any will of death yet. So if you're looking back from 2025 for something, you'll laugh how condescending I'll sound with this old machine. But this is very impressive in 2022. So I try to export 4K videos, which is 4.5 minutes. The new MacBook Pro finished the job in 94 seconds, and the old one took 444 seconds. That's about 470% improvement. Now for DaVinci Resolve. I use the same footages and the combined footage, so total 9 minutes of the 4K videos. I wasn't doing any editing at that point, but I just wanted to see how fast the new M1 Max will deliver. As you can see, I was already having trouble even loading up the videos on my old MacBook, while the new one was ready for me to at the first try. Contrary to my expectation, the speed up wasn't as dramatic as the QuickTime. 2021 MacBook Pro completed the task in 344 seconds, while the 2017 one did in 437 seconds. So that's only 25 improvement. Now that I'm editing this video, the speed up is more apparent at the looks and feel during the production phase. I can add the text, scroll around, and change the speed without any lag. Hello, this is the webcam and the mic test for my new and old MacBook Pro. This is how it sounds like with the 2017 MacBook Pro without any filter. And this is 2017, and this is how the 2017 webcam looked like, 720p. And this is how I sound with 2021 MacBook Pro any without any filter. And as you can see, the webcam is now full HD.
And this is how I sound with Snowball external mic.
Thanks for watching. Make safe room.